matter how much you feel you're not loved, God loves you regardless. And if you believe in your heart and ask for forgiveness, God forgives you.
Just like how sinless they forgave him.
Right. All right. I think we should go give Simba his award. Okay. I mean, he is a king. We probably shouldn't keep him waiting.
Oh, that is so true. I mean, I needed to get my cute safari outfit anyways.
Me too.
Alright. I have a quick question for you guys. What does a life look like before you come to Jesus? Or what does a life look like when you come to Jesus? Anybody know? Jonathan? Or
who's Jonathan?
Ethan.
Ian.
Ian. Alright, I'm so sorry.
Happy.
Happy. Love.
Heal.
Yeah, see, all those are great things. Life isn't sad or gloomy when you come to Jesus. It's happy, and it's brighter, and it's lighter, and you just feel so much better. You know, just like in the story, when Simba, he thought that he had killed his father. When really, Mufasa had told him that he killed his father, when really, Mufasa was the one who killed his father.
Scar kills Mufasa.
Yes, because he's a liar. And you know what? The devil will try to feed you lies like that. And if you don't hold Jesus dear to your heart, you will end up believing those lies. But that's why we hold Jesus dear to our heart, so we don't let the devil get anywhere close to us. All right, everybody say, stomp on the devil's head. Now you have to say a little bit more enthusiastically, okay? Stomp on the devil's head.
Stomp on the devil's head!
We say this in children's church because the devil cannot shine through the life of Jesus. Because the devil doesn't have that power, he doesn't have that strength. Jesus is light, and Jesus is strength, and Jesus is love. Just like Scar's lie didn't have enough power to shine through that whole story. In the end, Simba figured out that it really wasn't him who killed his father. And you know what? He was so scared to come back to his family. And when he went back, he was so shocked at how much they loved him and how much they cared for him and how much they really actually wanted to accept him back. It was really Simba the one who just didn't understand. Can I tell you guys a story? So, there was once this man. And he had a lot of money. I mean, a lot of money. Okay? A lot. And he had two sons. And one of the sons wanted half of his money. When he got of age, he was allowed to have half of his money, and he asked for it early. So he asked for the money early, and his dad said, okay, I wish you could have it, you know. So he got his money, and then he left out of town. And he bought all of his favorite toys. All of his favorite foods, he went partying, got all of his favorite drinks, you know, like Kool-Aid and stuff, and spent all of his money in a really quick amount of time. And soon, he ran out of all of his money, like, had like not even a penny. And he found himself sleeping with pigs. Yeah, ew, that's disgusting. I mean, can you imagine? You're all stinky, and you're all muddy. And gooey, and you're eating out of a pig trough. That is disgusting. So he sits there and he thinks, man, my father's servants ate better than I did. Matter of fact, my father's servants were clothed better than I was. Matter of fact, my father's servants were treated better than the way I am right now. So scared. He's so scared to walk because he's so scared his father's going to tell him no. He doesn't love him anymore and he gets lost. And he starts walking and then he sees his father walk out of the house. And he's like, oh my gosh. And his father doesn't walk, doesn't stand there. No. His father runs to his son. He runs full sprint all the way down a really long driveway. And when he gets to his son, he doesn't just stand there. He doesn't just look at him.
He gives him a hug.
Yeah, he puts him in a big embrace. And he bear hugs his son like your mommy and daddy bear hug you every day. And he squishes him. And his son says, please forgive me. I know I'm not worthy to be your son anymore, but please, take me to be your servant. And his father says, my son was once dead, but now he's alive. And his son is confused. He's like, wait, this doesn't make any sense. And then his father calls out to one servant and he says, go get my son the finest robe and the best jewelry that we have. And they run off to go get the stuff. And then he says to his other servant, go get the fattest chicken we got and put it in the oven. And you're going to slay the biggest lamb because we're going to have pork chops. Hang the biggest light and get the disco going because we're going to party. Because my son is home. You see, his father didn't accept him back with hate and with disregard. His father accepted him back with love and with hope, and he forgave him. You see, we all make mistakes, and Jesus forgives you no matter what you've been through, no matter what you've done. Jesus loves you. Jesus cares for you. And that's the great thing about being a Christian and being a child of God, which every single one of you guys are. All right, so now they're going to turn on some worship music, and we're going to all bow our heads. You're going to repeat after me. Dear Lord, I just love you. I thank you, Lord, for everything you do for me. I thank you, Lord, for forgiving me and loving me no matter what. You are awesome. Now they're going to